The Economist Intelligence Unit, EIU, says the National Democratic Congress will lose the 2020 elections. According to a report monitored in Accra, the NDC will not recover from the loss it suffered in the last general elections. The Business Intelligence Unit, in its latest report on Ghana, says the Akufo-Addo's government is still regarded as a better custodian of the economy compared to the opposition leader John Dramani Mahama. In September last year, the EIU released a similar report suggesting the NPP will secure re-election in 2020. According to the report, it will be difficult for the opposition NDC under former President John Mahama to portray itself as a better custodian of Ghana's economy, especially as the country's growth outlook looks fairly strong. Meanwhile, the opposition National Democratic Congress says its candidate, John Dramani Mahama, will be elected president in the election. Nana Akufo-Addo, in the 2016 elections, beat then-president John Dramani Mahama by polling 5,716,026 votes, representing 53.85%, while John Mahama polled 4,713,277 votes, representing 44.40%, the worst so far for an incumbent president. We're hoping to speak to Jonathan Asante Orchard, and Jonathan is a senior lecturer with the University of Ghana and a political analyst. Jonathan, good evening and welcome to News 360.
Good evening to all the viewers of TV3.
It's good to have you on the line because we've been struggling to reach you, actually.
Yeah, I think the network is a little bad.
Right.
But so, the correction is that it's the University of Cape Coast.
You are with the University of Cape Coast?
Yes.
Thank you for the immediate correction. We're grateful for that. And so, Jonathan, are you aware of the Economic Intelligence Unit's report, which says that the NDC will lose, the main opposition party will not be able to recover from the loss it suffered in 2016?
Well, yeah, I have just read the report. And I think that from their perspective, they seem to be consistent with their pronouncement. I do not really know the methodology that they used anyway, but it seeks to more or less rubbish the assessment that were done previously by other, you know, afro barometers, like, for example, the ASEPAS, the likes of Imani Ghana, Imani Africa, you know, and the likes of those that were done by the University of Ghana Political Science Department, and then the Afro Barometer itself by the IEE. Now, I think that if something of that sort has come out from their end, it is good for the ruling government. But I remember that in their previous report that came, they sought to suggest that, for example, if the ruling government is able to fulfill most of the promises and to ensure that the economy is well stable, then probably they are likely to edge, you know, the NDC out of the elections in terms of winning.
Yes.
But you see, the pronouncement, the anger that they are coming from, that the NDC is not likely to recover, it's as if it is like the number that won the MPP the election, it is a static number. I dare say that between the NDC and the MPP, they need the floating voters to be able to win. They're not aligned to be able to win. None of them can have the 50 plus one from the core membership. Now, it then seems to suggest that the number that helped the ruling government then in a position to win was as a result of probably people who are not aligned. And because of the campaign that were run by the party then in opposition and now in government, that's the more reason why they were able to succeed. But you see, some of these polls can sometimes be a bit deceptive and may let you go and sleep. We were here when we had so many polls in the 2016 elections in the United States, all mostly predicting against Donald Trump.
Yeah.
And he edged against Madame Clinton. And so I think that this report, more or less, you know, ought to let the government feel a bit free. Of course, they have been under severe pressure owing to the reports that have come from four different, you know, units. And so if this one has come, it is a plus for them. They may need to work hard. But some of us think that these things are not really, you know, the actual barometer by which, you know, Ghanaians will look out to vote for this or that. But
right. Jonathan, if you can hear me a little, I mean, do you think things can change before December 2020, particularly when there are other parties apart from the NPP that is being touted as a party that is most likely to win the 2020 elections? The NDC, the PNC, and the APC, the other opposition parties. What do you suggest they should do as a political analyst?
Well, I think that the party in opposition, the main party in opposition, that is NDC, of course, they need to be aligning themselves one way or the other. There should be some kind of broad consultation with the opposition parties to be able to get a certain number. But I am equally of the view that the floating voters will be the decider, because the economy that they are talking about, as they being the better managers of the economy, I mean, we are all in this country, you know, the kind of price increment here and there, you know, cost of commodities rising, you know, at a rocket pace, the dollar appreciating against the cedi, and you can see all of these things. But you see, it is early days yet. We need to wait till probably 6 months to the elections. You see, don't forget that there are even labor agitations behind the scenes. You know, the collapse of the banks that have more or less increased unemployment. You know, so all these restlessness are rearing their ugly heads in the system. And so I think that the government ought to work a little harder. And if they really want to overly rely on some of these reports, I think that it will be a big problem for them.
Right. Thank you, Jonathan. We were just trying to find out what value you actually place on such report, but I think you've already answered it. Thank you, Jonathan Asante-Ochiri, Senior Lecturer with the University of Cape Coast and Political Analyst as well.